sister.
First four bars.
Oop, starting to sprinkle.
First four bars.
Yeah. How are you? Good to see you. Welcome, happy Easter. Welcome, happy Easter. How are you doing? Thank you for your service. Happy Easter. Happy Easter. Happy Easter. God bless.
I have a bag full from all the truckers over.
Happy Easter. God bless.
I got a whole bag full. I got some from Steve. I got
happy Easter.
Happy Easter.
Happy Easter.
Thank you. I invite you to please stand and let us greet each other. with an Easter greeting. Alleluia, he is risen. Let us join in singing, Jesus Christ is risen today.
The Son and of the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
The grace of our Lord Jesus Christ, the love of God, and the communion of the Holy Spirit be with you all. Welcome everyone to this family mass on this Easter Sunday here at St. Denis at our family masses, which we have every other week at 1 p.m. The children actively participate in every part of the mass, including sitting down with me to discuss the readings. So please bring your children every other week to this 1 p.m. Mass. To prepare ourselves to celebrate the sacred mysteries, let's first acknowledge our sins. Lord Jesus, you raise us to new life. Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
Lord Jesus, you forgive us our sins. Christ, have mercy. Lord Jesus, you feed us with your body and blood. Lord, have mercy. May Almighty God have mercy on us, forgive us our sins, and bring us to everlasting life.
Thank you.
Let us pray. O God, who on this day, through your only begotten Son, have conquered death and unlocked for us the path to eternity, grant, we pray, that we, who keep the solemnity of the Lord's resurrection, may, through the renewal brought by your Spirit, rise up in the light of life. Through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, God forever and ever.
A reading from the Acts of the Apostles. Peter proceeded to speak and said, "You know what has happened all over Judea, beginning in Galilee after the baptism that John preached, how God anointed Jesus of Nazareth with the Holy Spirit and power. He went about doing good and healing all those oppressed by the devil, for God was with him. We are witnesses of all that he did both in the country of the Jews and in Jerusalem. They put him to death by hanging him on a tree. This man God raised on the third day and granted that he be visible, not to all the people, but to us, the witnesses chosen by God in advance, who ate and drank with him after he rose from the dead. He commissioned us to preach to the people and testify that he is the one appointed by God as judge of the living and the dead. To him all the prophets bear witness that everyone who believes in him will receive forgiveness of sins through his name." The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Thank you. A reading from the letter of St. Paul to the Colossians. Brothers and sisters, if then you were raised with Christ, seek what is above, where Christ is seated at the right hand of God. Think of what is above, not of what is on earth. For you have died, and your life is hidden with Christ in God. When Christ, your life appears, then you too will appear with him glory. The word of the Lord.
Pascali laudessimo lent Christiani. Christ the Lamb has saved the sheep, Christ the Just One paid the price, reconciling sinners to the Father. Death and life fought bitterly for this wondrous victory. The Lord of life who died reigns glorified. O Mary, come and say what you saw at break of day. The empty tomb of my living Lord saw Christ Jesus risen and adored. Angels testified, shroud and grave cloth side by side. Yes, Christ, my hope, rose gloriously. He goes before you into Galilee. Share the good news, sing joyfully. His death is victory. Jesus, Victor King, show us mercy. Amen. Alleluia.
from the Holy Gospel according to Mark. On the first day of the week, Mary of Magdala came to the tomb early in the morning while it was still dark and saw the stone removed from the tomb. So she ran and went to Simon Peter and to the other disciples whom Jesus loved and told them, "They have taken the Lord from the tomb and we do not know where they put him." So Peter and the other disciples went out and came to the tomb. They both ran, but the other disciple ran faster than Peter and arrived at the tomb first. He bent down and saw the burial cloths there, but did not go in. When Simon Peter arrived after him, he went into the tomb and saw the burial cloths there and the cloth that had covered his head, not with the burial cloths, but rolled up in a separate place. Then the other disciples also went in, the one who had arrived at the tomb first, and he saw and believed, for they did not yet understand the scriptures that he had to rise from the dead. The Gospel of the Lord.
Children to join me down here. Just leave some room for me in the chair, the rocking chair. There's some room over here. Happy Easter, everyone. How you doing? Are you happy that Easter is finally here? But before we talk about Easter, let's be careful with your hands in my rocking chair. Before we talk about Easter, let's talk about what happened a week ago on Palm Sunday. Do you remember Palm Sunday, last Sunday? Did you all get some palms, maybe, when you came? And did you do anything with the palms? Did you make anything out of them? You got some palms with your hand raised? What did you do with the palms? Did you make something out of it? You made a cross out of it? That's what I was doing at your age. And the little girl here, did you get some palms?
I made a cross.
She made a cross as well. That's great. Who else made a cross? Raise your hand. That's good. So, we got the palms on Palm Sunday. Do you remember the long gospel from Palm Sunday? Oh, you're way over here. Okay. Do you remember the long gospel from Palm Sunday? You do? Okay. We can somehow. What do you remember from the gospel from Palm Sunday?
I remember that one of his disciples denied him three times.
That's true. And that would be Peter, denied knowing Jesus. He denied him three times. What happened to Jesus, though, in the gospel as it progressed?
he died on the cross.
Yes, he was crucified on a cross, and then of course he died on the cross, right? You can give the microphone back. What happened? So after Jesus died on the cross, what happened to his body? Do you remember that? Maybe the boy right there?
He got buried.
Yes. So one of his friends came along, took the body off the cross and buried it. And what kind of tomb was Jesus buried in? Do you remember? It wasn't like a normal tomb that we would think of. It was a place, it was a cave. So he was buried in a cave, and then they had to roll a big stone in front of the cave. And so that's how Jesus was buried. So on Good Friday, Jesus died on the cross. His body was taken down from the cross and buried in a tomb, which was a cave. And this big stone was rolled in front of the cave to protect the body. And then what do we read of today's gospel? Today is the Easter Sunday. So just, 3 days, depending how you count, from Good Friday, Easter Sunday, Mary Magdalene went to the tomb, and what did she find? How about the boy in the yellow?
She saw that Jesus wasn't there.
She found that Jesus wasn't there? She also, how did she know that?
Because
what happened to the stone?
It got moved.
Yes, the stone was moved away from the entrance to the cave. So yes. And then she ran in the gospel today. Mary Magdalene ran to tell Peter and another disciple that Jesus' body wasn't in the tomb anymore. And she thought that someone had taken it. So Peter and the other disciple went to the tomb and they saw the same thing. And they were just as surprised as Mary Magdalene. But what do we know? Did someone actually take Jesus' body out of the tomb? So how did Jesus' body get out of the tomb? What happened to his body? The girl in the glasses? Hey, wait for the microphone. He
rose from the dead.
He rose from the dead, bodily rose from the dead. Excellent. And so that's what we're celebrating today, Jesus' resurrection, his bodily resurrection from the dead. And he wants to share his resurrection and his new life with all of us. And he does that by, when we get close to Jesus in our daily life, then, and through our baptism as well, he'll share his resurrection with us too. So we want to be close to Jesus in our daily life so that when the time comes, we'll share in his resurrection and his eternal life in heaven. So what are some ways that we in our daily life can stay close to Jesus? Yes. Right here. How can we stay close to Jesus in our daily life?
By praying.
We can pray, for sure. Yes. So there are many different ways to pray. Do all of you know how to pray the Our Father? Yes, maybe. We pray it at every Mass. Do you know how to pray a Hail Mary? That's good too. Some of you are younger than others, haven't yet learned it. That's okay. So we can pray using those prayers, but we can also pray just using our own words. We could talk to Jesus in prayer, and just share with Jesus when we pray everything that's going on in our life. All the things we're excited about, all the things we're worried about, everything that's happening in our life, we can just tell Jesus in our words when we pray. And along the way, we might even ask Jesus, what should I do about this thing that I'm worried about. You know, maybe you have some big project to do at school. You could ask Jesus, well, what should I do for my science project? Or what should I write for my essay in English class? You can do all that. And then if you're worried about a big game or maybe a track meet or something, you can pray about that and ask Jesus, what should I do to prepare for this big event? So we get close to Jesus by praying. How else do we stay close to Jesus in our daily life? Can you think of another way? Yes. Can we get a microphone? Here we go.
You can go to church.
We can go to church, for sure. We'll talk about that next, but I want to talk about something else before that. A third way where we can get close to Jesus. I see right, way back there, and her hand is up. Yes, if you could, yeah, the one, the girl in the glasses.
By reading the Bible.
Reading the Bible, yes, for sure. So the Gospels are all about Jesus, so we want to read those every day, at least some part of the Gospel every day, so we get closer to Jesus. And the whole Old Testament is pointing toward Jesus, and the New Testament is all about him. So, it's good to pray it's good to read the Bible, even pray with the Bible every day. Do you have your own Bible, children? Do you have a, if you have a Bible, raise your personal Bible. Very good. Do you have a Bible at home, your own Bible, personal Bible? Maybe a children's Bible? So parents, I recommend making sure your children have a children's Bible. And you can buy that on Amazon. Look for a Catholic children's Bible. Yeah, and then they can start reading it. And that's how we stay, another way we stay close to Jesus is by reading the Bible, especially the Gospels. And then let's go back to the third way we stay close to Jesus. And what is that again? By going to church, for sure. Going to Sunday Mass. So, I hope you and your parents are coming to Sunday Mass every week. But if you're not, you can ask your mom and dad to take you, like next week or next Sunday. You can say on maybe Friday or Saturday, Mom, Dad, what Mass are we going to on Sunday? And hopefully they'll tell you, oh, we'll go to the 9 a.m. Mass, we'll go to the 11 a.m. Mass, we'll go to the 1 p.m. Mass. So plan to go to Mass every week. Ask your parents to take you if they don't normally do that. Yeah, and parents, if your kids ask you to go to Mass, to take them to Mass, please do take them. We'd love to have them, and we'd love to have you too. And then also in the Mass, we meet Jesus and stay close to him through, especially I would say, a sacrament. What sacrament is that we receive at Mass? The girl here in the...
Yeah. During the Holy Communion?
Through Holy Communion, for sure. Yes. So we receive Jesus in Holy Communion. We get close to him and stay close to him by going to Sunday Mass every week. We stay close to Jesus and get to know him better and better by reading the Bible, especially the Gospels, every day if possible. And we stay close to Jesus, too, by praying every day, including just using our own words. And if we stay close to Jesus in our daily life in all these ways, you know, we have great hope and faith that we will stay close to Jesus in his resurrection and in his life in heaven. And that's what we all want. So, thank you, kids. Oh, I don't want you to... Careful, under there. I don't want you to get hurt. So thank you all for sitting down with me to discuss the Gospel on this Easter Sunday. We have something special planned after this, so I'm just going to ask you... Oh, wait. No. I think I have to, what am I going to do? What was that? Yeah, no, okay. We're going to do a sprinkling rite. I think we're going to try to work around. We're going to have the, I don't know how we're going to do this, with all the kids here. we'll have you go to your seats. And we have a sprinkling rite, so we'll do that. So get up, everyone, the children. Go back to your seats. Thank you for sitting down with me. I need my book, my binder. Okay. Yeah. So, my dear brothers and sisters, through the Paschal mystery, we have been buried with Christ in baptism so that we may walk with him in newness of life. And so now that our Lenten observance is concluded, let us renew the promises of holy baptism by which we once renounced Satan and his works and promised to serve God in the Holy Catholic Church. And so I'm going to ask you a series of questions. And actually, I'll ask everyone to please stand. Thank you. So I'll ask you a series of questions. And the response to each of these questions will be, I do. And those of you who are married said something like that when you got married, right? I do. So we take it with the same solemnity when we say I do to these questions. And so I ask all of you, do you renounce sin so as to live in the freedom of the children of God?
I do.
Do you renounce the lure of evil so that sin may have no mastery over you?
I do.
Do you renounce Satan, the author and prince of sin?
I do.
Do you believe in God, the Father Almighty, creator of heaven and earth?
I do.
Do you believe in Jesus Christ, his only Son, our Lord, who was born of the Virgin Mary, suffered death and was buried, rose again from the dead, and is seated at the right hand of the Father?
I do.
Do you believe in the Holy Spirit, the Holy Catholic Church, the communion of saints, the forgiveness of sins, the resurrection of the body, and life everlasting?
I do.
And may Almighty God, the Father of our Lord Jesus Christ, who has given us new birth by water and the Holy Spirit, and bestowed on us forgiveness of our sins, keep us by his grace in Christ Jesus our Lord for eternal life. Amen. And now, as a reminder of our baptism, Deacon Al and I will go around and sprinkle everyone with holy water.
Oh,
With immense joy and gratitude, we lift up our hearts to our loving God.
That the power of the resurrection will fill the church, empowering each Christian to spread the good news of Jesus Christ. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
That the peace of the risen Christ, which surpasses all understanding, will wash over our nation and world, bringing unity and harmony. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
That the newly baptized and those newly received into the church will continue their lifelong journey into the Paschal mystery. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
That the risen Christ who suffered death out of love for us will renew our parish this Easter and give us an ever greater share of his spirit. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For the special intentions of Brett G. Green, Michael Sutandar, Samuel Naylor, Christian Reyes, Evelyn Mesa, for whom this Mass is offered and for those who have requested our prayers. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For the sick, including Mike Shea, Leticia Lanson, Brandon Bang, Maylard Baral, Mark Munoz, Rhea Reyes, Kua Lo, Adrian Pena, Christian Jimenez, Jessica Sanchez, Ruben Hernandez. Will be healed in a bodily spirit, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
That those who have died, including Raymond Bergardon, Francisco Santos, Mauro Gonzalez Rodriguez, all the unborn children, that they will share in Jesus' resurrection, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For those who need our prayers and for all the prayer intentions that are listed in the comment section of YouTube and Facebook for this Mass.
Not yet, Mom.
We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer. Heavenly Father, graciously hear our prayers through your risen Son, our Lord Jesus Christ. Amen. And please be seated.
Please drop off your donation for St. Denis in one of the collection baskets or boxes. People in the courtyard are requested to use the collection boxes. In addition, you may mail in your donation. Alternatively, you may support St. Denis electronically through online giving or PayPal. To donate in these ways, please click on the give link or the stewardship link towards the top of our website, stdenis.org. That is stdenis.org. Thank you so much for supporting St. Denis financially.
And I'll also invite all of the children who are in the pews to go down this main aisle to the back of the church to participate in our offertory as we normally do. We change things up a little bit because of the sprinkling, but you can go to the back of the church and join us. At these family masses, we want to make sure that the children have something to do practically all the time. We don't want them to ever get bored or fidgety.
Okay. Please join in singing Alleluia, Give the Glory. Music is also available on our website at stdenis.org. St. Denis, stdenis.org. A worship aid is found there, a link to our worship aid on our website if you'd like to follow along there as well.
Hallelujah.
Thank you.
Pray, my brothers and sisters, that my sacrifice and yours may be acceptable to God, the Almighty Father. Exultant with paschal gladness, O Lord, we offer the sacrifice by which your church is wondrously reborn and nourished through Christ our Lord. Now, normally at this point in the Mass, I would invite the children to come up, but I think we would be overrun up here by so many children, so it's great to see all of the children here today. But next Sunday, next time we do it in 2 weeks, I'm sure we'll have room up here for all the children. The Lord be with you. Lift up your hearts. Let us give thanks to the Lord our God. It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, at all times to acclaim you, O Lord, but on this day, above all, to laud you yet more gloriously when Christ our Passover has been sacrificed. For he is the true Lamb who has taken away the sins of the world. By dying, he has destroyed our death, and by rising, restored our life. Therefore, overcome with paschal joy, every land, every people exults in your praise, and even the heavenly powers with the angelic hosts sing together the unending hymn of your glory as they acclaim. Holy, O Lord, the fount of all holiness. Make holy, therefore, these gifts, we pray, by sending down your Spirit upon them like the dewfall, so that they may become for us the body and blood of our Lord Jesus Christ. At the time he was betrayed and entered willingly into his passion, he took bread, and giving thanks, broke it, and gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and eat of it, for this is my body, which will be given up for you." In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice, and once more giving thanks, he gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it, for this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me." The mystery of faith. Therefore, as we celebrate the memorial of his death and resurrection, we offer you, Lord, the bread of life and the chalice of salvation, giving thanks that you have held us worthy to be in your presence and minister to you. Humbly we pray that, partaking of the body and blood of Christ, we may be gathered into one by the Holy Spirit. Remember, Lord, your church spread throughout the world, and bring her to the fullness of charity, together with Francis, our Pope, Jose, our Bishop, and all the clergy. Remember also our brothers and sisters who have fallen asleep in the hope of the resurrection, and all who have died in your mercy. Welcome them into the light of your face. Have mercy on us all, we pray, that with the Blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, with Blessed Joseph, her spouse, with the blessed apostles, and all the saints who have pleased you throughout the ages, we may merit to be co-heirs to eternal life, and may praise and glorify you through your Son, Jesus Christ. Through him and with him and in him, O God, Almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours forever and ever. Savior's command, and formed by divine teaching, we dare to say, Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from Deliver us, Lord, we pray, from every evil. Graciously grant peace in our days, that by the help of your mercy, we may be always free from sin and safe from all distress, as we await the blessed hope and the coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ. Lord Jesus Christ, who said to your apostles, Peace I leave you, my peace I give you. Look not on our sins, but on the faith of your church, and graciously grant her peace and unity in accordance with your will, who live and reign forever and ever. Amen. The peace of the Lord be with you always.
And with your spirit. Let us offer each other the sign of peace.
Thank you.
Behold the Lamb of God. Behold him who takes away the sins of the world. Blessed are those called to the supper of the Lamb. Lord, I am not worthy
that you should enter under my roof, but only say the word and my soul shall be healed.
For everyone who is celebrating Mass with us from home, let's pray together the act of spiritual communion. My Jesus, I believe that you are present in the most holy sacrament. I love you above all things, and I desire to receive you into my soul. Since I cannot at this moment receive you sacramentally, come at least spiritually into my heart. I embrace you as if you were already there, and unite myself wholly to you. Never permit me to be separated from you. Amen. For Holy Communion, if you would like to receive the body of Christ or a blessing, please come down the aisle in the usual way. If you are not Catholic, or if you're not actively practicing the faith at this time, please come forward for a blessing. To indicate that, just cross your arms over your chest like this. If you would like to receive both the body and blood of Christ on your tongue, please come down the aisle in the usual way and just go around the First Communion minister and go to the nearest intinction minister. There'll be one intinction minister on each side of the church. And when you reach that minister, please line up on the right or left side instead of in front in order to avoid blocking the aisles. And for those of you upstairs, we will send a Eucharistic minister upstairs to bring you Holy Communion.
Jesus lives.
Let us pray.
One more. One more.
Look upon your church, O God, with unfailing love and favor, so that, renewed by the Paschal mysteries, she may come to the glory of the resurrection. Through Christ our Lord. Please be seated for a few announcements. I'm just going to hit the highlights, I assure you. During this Easter week, we're focusing on Divine Mercy as we prepare for Divine Mercy Sunday, which is next Sunday. Therefore, every day from today through next Saturday, we will pray the Divine Mercy Novena in the chapel. Today and next Saturday, we'll pray it, the novena, at 3 p.m. in the chapel, because that time is called the Hour of Divine Mercy, because that's the hour when Jesus died on the cross. Monday through Friday, though, we will pray the Divine Mercy novena in the chapel at 6 p.m., just before the 6:30 p.m. weekday Mass. Next Sunday, we will celebrate Divine Mercy Sunday at the 1 p.m. Mass with help from our Divine Mercy singers. Then at 2 p.m., we will have our Divine Mercy celebration, including Eucharistic adoration and the Divine Mercy prayers and benediction. The 1 p.m. Mass and Divine Mercy celebration that follows also will be live streamed. Afterward, next Sunday, we'll go to the hall for free refreshments, music, and fellowship. To learn all about Divine Mercy and St. Faustina and her diary, which focuses on Divine Mercy, please join Deacon Al for his three-part series on Divine Mercy. He did the first session of his series on Wednesday, March 20th, and you can find a recording of this session on our YouTube channel and Facebook page. He did the second session last Wednesday, but the live stream had major technical difficulties. And so he'll repeat the second session tomorrow, Monday at 7, from 7:30 to 9 p.m. here in the church. And this session also will be live streamed. Then on Wednesday, he'll do the third session of his series, Wednesday from 7:30 to 9 p.m. in the church, and it too will be live streamed. On the first Sunday of every month, including next Sunday, we have a Sunday youth gathering at 4 p.m. in the hall, followed by a life teen mass at 5:30 p.m. The Sunday youth gathering is for all teens in high school. At these youth gatherings, the teens socialize, enjoy refreshments, and learn about the faith. Afterward, they can stay and participate in our life teen mass at 5:30 p.m. next Sunday. Our life team masses have lively contemporary music with our youth mass band, and the teens actively participate in various parts of the mass, including sitting down with the priest to discuss the readings. Also on the first Sunday of every month, including next Sunday, we take up a second collection for our building and maintenance fund. In addition, the first Sunday is called Contribution Sunday because we collect non-perishable food for 200 poor families from St. Madeline's Parish in Pomona. If you bring dry food or food in cans or jars next weekend, you can drop it off in a bin in the courtyard. As I mentioned before, every other Sunday at 1 p.m., including in 2 weeks, on Sunday, April 14th, we have a special family mass at 1 p.m. for families with children in grade 8 and younger. At these biweekly family masses, as you just saw, the children actively participate in every part of the Mass, including sitting down with usually me to discuss the readings. Then in 2 weeks, on Sunday, April 14th at 2 p.m., that is after the family Mass, we'll have an Easter celebration for children in the courtyard, followed by lunch in the hall. In the courtyard, the children will act out 6 different times that Jesus appeared to people after his resurrection. And the children will have a chance to participate in several fun activities related to Jesus's post-resurrection appearances. Afterward, we'll go to the hall for a nice lunch, which will consist of baked Italian pasta, a nice green salad, garlic bread, desserts, and drinks. The cost for the lunch is only $5. In addition, the Easter Bunny will be in the hall, and we'll have Easter candy to ensure that the kids have a good time. So please bring your children and grandchildren to our family mass in 2 weeks, 1 p.m., and our Easter celebration at 2 p.m. that same day. On behalf of Father Denis, Deacon Al, Deacon Denis, and the entire staff at St. Denis, we hope that you and your family have a very blessed and happy Easter Sunday, and a very blessed and happy Easter week. One last thing, we have Easter baskets for the children, and we'll distribute them after the conclusion, the official conclusion of the Mass. and they're located here and here under these colored cloths. So if you have a child with you, please stay and send them up to get the Easter basket that we have prepared for them. And please stand. The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit. Bow your heads for the blessing.
May Almighty God bless you through today's Easter solemnity, and in his compassion, defend you from every assault of sin. Amen.
Amen.
And may he who restores you to eternal life in the resurrection of his only begotten endow you with the prize of immortality.
Amen. Amen.
Now that the days of the Lord's Passion have drawn to a close, may you who celebrate the gladness of the Paschal Feast come with Christ's help and exulting in spirit to those feasts that are celebrated in eternal joy.
Amen.
And may the blessing of Almighty God, the Father, and the Son, and the Holy Spirit come down upon you and remain with you forever.
The Mass has ended. Go in peace. Alleluia. Alleluia.
Thanks be to God. Alleluia.